We have no time to waste, Telly. Off to Echo Canyon and the Lair of Trial. I guess that's that cave we saw in the area intro. Let's go. So we can do Telly with battles on the way, but Sand Firefly itself or the cave itself? Luta, good luck! Thanks, Sabony. Well, I actually thanked her for once. I might have gone to the canyon very early in the morning and placed some satchels with ribbon bee jelly for you to find. Wait, what? So you traversed the canyon yourself just so you could help Luta indirectly without the chief medicine? It's also to say the least. It seems like I wasn't the only one who placed a few satchels there. Fish bones in my throat. What exactly is going on here? Luta, you don't have much time. You don't want the sun to set before you go down there. Right, let's get going. And you forgot your bow. And your spear. Right, so we've got different types of weapons, so we can use various things. Look how big the world is compared to my small little body. Okay, I do like that we can see like the big river on the map.
Oh, so talking makes me yawn.
Ooh, alright, chin up, man. Let's go over traversing narrow passages. If I move the camera all the way so that I see myself from top down perspective, and tight corridors should be easy to get through. Yep. Right, okay. Do the first one, then. Okay. Just typical JRPG stuff. I know it said make your camera vertical, but I prefer how it looks like this. So this looks like a flying type beast. Yep, a Zubat. And I wonder, does it cost a turn for me to change weapon? It does not. So you can do that without penalty. Was that super effective though? It didn't make a special sound effect or anything, though. Oh, okay. Well, that did like 70 damage before. Oh yeah, that it must have been super effective. If I change to my soaked hatchet, it only does 54. I imagine my bow was super effective then. So, you're just Teddy. Telly, sorry, not Teddy. Equip, so, short bow. Right, and I was wondering if it's like a type indicator, but it says water element there. And it also says weapon type, because obviously different weapons are super effective against different types as well. Toxic residue has been found. Body weight cut has been learned by Telly. Huh. Let's go right. Oh, so it's not only overworld encounters, we also get this kind of stuff. I guess I'll try a spear? I don't know. Right, so it attacks twice because that's like what spears do sometimes. So I guess spears might not be super effective against anything in particular. They just sometimes attack twice. No, that's not heal yet. So I go equip. We'll just try to so catch it. I missed! This snake! And so what's Telly's thing? Uses body weight to cut. I guess it's just like a strong hit. I missed. Okay, you know what? Let's run. Escape. What? Escape. I was unable to escape. Oh, the snake is there. I just completely missed it. Okay, I think I need to eat some jelly. Well, it did not heal that much though. We could not. We might not do well here. Let's save, just in case. I mean, this thing must be like an Earth-type beast, right? Let's try it. Oh, there's a lot of Earth-type beasts. Okay, and weapon is so catchy. Trapinch A. Yeah, I think that's got to be super effective. That was a lot of damage. Maybe. I don't know. I'm confused. There must be an indicator, something like a sound effect, right? I'm just not too aware of how this game operates yet, I guess. They're doing a lot of damage, and I'm out of healing items, so to speak. So, do I go to my last save, or...? I come back here. I'm on 1 HP. Let's march on. There might be a healing spot before the cave or something. Oh, campfire, that's what they said, right? Yeah. Yes, I would like to rest. Thank God. Perfect timing. So I get a feeling we're a bit underleveled. Because those trepinches really tore me a new one. A Gagoat. It's like, is Gagoat Earth type? Or is it not? It's the same sound effect. I mean, that's the same damage. So that's not super effective, right? I don't know, I hope there's a Pokédex or something, because it is a bit confusing knowing what's right and what's not. Guess we'll see. Game design-wise, I imagine the water hatchet will be super effective on the Volcarona or the sand butterfly. We don't know it's a Volcarona yet, just because of that's like the weapon we had to craft as part of the tutorial. Place is making me dizzy. You are a good scout, so what do you propose to come that way? But generally speaking, one should always use certain landmarks man-made and not as orientation points. So I think we're just saying like use this big spike to know where we're coming from. Seems like it'll be an easy game to get lost in. Hyena, okay. Did he just attack both of us in one hit? What a little bitch. I know dogs are probably related to hyenas. We're not doing too well, are we? My gosh. Oh, and of course you miss. At least there's no real penalty for dying and we just return to the last fire. We gotta take down the hyena. I mean, if we can't defeat these basic enemies, we don't stand a chance against... Oh! Okay, I'll have to remember that, because I feel like that's definitely a piece of feedback that could be given. It feels weird that you go back to the rest point after fainting, but you don't come back to full health. Dun dun. Okay, let's try that again. This hyena is really getting the best of me. Okay. Oh, no, I'll try a different weapon on one of Looter then. Spear. So this might attack twice. 57 damage. Yeah, similar damage, but it's neutral. But it can attack twice, and so that if I'm going against something that's neutral, attacking twice is just like a better bet. Okay, we've leveled up, and let's go back and heal. Because God knows we need it. God knows I'm lost as well. Ooh. Okay. What's down here? Maybe some butterfly jelly? Or we can ascend. How interesting. Let's lower the camera, get a nice view of this beautiful landscape. Yes, a hatchet. So now we have soaked hatchet and hatchet. Right, okay. We only have one craft in this big idea. Dead end? I did see an item down there, so if I can loop around, maybe. Oh, and an item here. Ribbon bee jelly? I see another item. What's up here? More ribbon wow! Pony really got out there placing the jelly about. I'm very thankful. Let's rotate. Okay. I don't really know where I'm going. It's a really big map. I know they said to keep an eye out for landmarks, but like, I don't know, it's tough, man. Okay. I mean, I imagine going higher in general is good. I don't know, at least I'm just finding items. A short bow? That must be good. I'm lost. I'm lost. Yeah, we came from here. But did we go down here? Dead end, okay. Really cool map. What's that down there? I see something there. Must be a Pokemon or something. I haven't been up here, have I? I think it's just an item. Okay. So I can go down. I don't want to go down yet. Having a high up view is quite useful. Milk tank kefir. Huh? Oh, so it's a big, big potion. That's good to have. I like that there's a little floating bird in there as well. That's cool. I wonder if one day we'll get an ability to soar. I highly doubt it, but it would be very epic. Okay, so I'll try going down now. If there is a hyena there... No. I was like, maybe that pillar is a pillar I walked by before, but that's a snake, not a hyena, so it's not. Oh god, this all looks so familiar. So I can go down here. Again, I don't really know where the end goal is. I guess if I have a camera more like this, I might be able to see. I want to enter a cave. Oh, there's an item there. Is that the campfire I found before? Is that a new campfire? That's the same campfire because I see the tall spike in the background. Right, and then this is where I was before. Because I came up here. I mean, we got some audio here. There's a path leading this way. Maybe I just go this way, right? That makes sense. A Geodude. Okay, you're definitely Earth type, so you can use a water hatchet. And hopefully destroy you. Attack. Be a live rock. Yeah, you get him. Keep on beating up that rock. Oh, he's a tangy little rock. Especially considering, like, if it wasn't for the hatchet, it seems like it'd be doing like 15 damage. I've got rock residue. Good to get all these items, I suppose. I imagine after the tutorial we'll get a big recipe book of like all the different elemental weapons. Maybe. Or maybe it'll be depending on what area we go to. Oh, where the fuck am I? No, what? Okay, we got an item. I'm lost. Ugh. And I'm getting sleepy apparently. It is getting late at night. I didn't sleep that much last night. I've got an early start tomorrow. But I've got an early start every day, it seems like. Okay, we're back at the river. I don't think this is where we're supposed to be. Oh. I'll try working my way back. Because I got a cutscene in my bear, which means it must be like a vague right direction. Up here? And then we got the tall rock? Like up here is a tall rock, right? No. Here. Yeah, this is right way. I must pay close attention to my surroundings. They must have realized that people are going to get lost in this game, because there's a lot of dialogue telling us to pay attention to landmarks and whatnot. It's like, even paying attention, it's still quite hard, you know? But I'll do my best to remember the way we came. But even now, I know I'm going the right way and I'm still lost. I think up is good. Up is good. Can I get a camera angle on this? Do I see a cave entrance anywhere? I see another campfire. That must be good. Let's go here, get this item. I'm glad there's no wild meaning. Okay.
I'm excited. Oh god, I'm sleepy.
I'm glad there's no, like, random encounters, because otherwise I would be having a lot of encounters as I get lost around this canyon. Okay, but new bonfire reached, hell yeah. So I guess we walk around the river now? Oh no, but we do get an item. A ring robe. Body? Made out of Earth's Ring Hide, raises evasion and defense. How do I... Oh, what's the shortcut for that? Because I can use my mouse to click it. Page up, yeah. And yeah, we'll put Land Clothing on you. Okay. Do I need to go backwards then? Or here? No, that's dead end. Back up? That beast is just chilling up there. Let's try taking down another Geodude. We gotta get XP, we can't be too weak. And a live rock. I've got better defense now. Ooh. You feel that better defense, Geodude? You can't even touch us now. Just keep on slapping the rock till it's wet. Okay, another item, but is that it? Another hatchet? Okay. Oh god, where am I? I've never seen an X-type formation, but this is a different X formation, right? Where the fuck am I? Yeah, we're going up lots, that must be good. Page up. I'm looking for a cave entrance. That I cannot find. But I seem to have found another bonfire. Down there. Oh god. Way. Come on. Poison spear, that's big. I can probably make that, right? Oh, I only have one toxic residue. I need one more. So I guess that's how I get other recipes. I just have to find them as I go through the area. I'm so lost. I had the dialogue tell me I was going the right way, but then the path just branched out and got even more complex. This looks right. So I saw him. No, I didn't. It was a different one I saw. I'm finding new items, which means I'm going in a new direction. And you, another big potion. Okay, let's go top down view. I'm lost. I'm lost. I've been up here. Golly gosh. Is this going to be the whole game? I thought this sand butterfly was a tutorial, but maybe it's the whole game, trying to find it in this maze. I need some kind of like direction indicator. So I came here and here's a bonfire, but it's a dead end, right? Like I just got some items. Yeah? Yeah. I can't surf, can I? No. I've been around here, I got an item this way. So I came from here, maybe there's just another way to go if I go even further back. Sword spear? Another item? I guess if anybody complains about Game Freak maps being too linear, just chuck from this game. This is pretty damn complex as far as maps go, especially for the the first route you ever go on. And it's this motherfucker of a map. Why does this tile look different? Is it a perspective thing? I guess it's just a bit different. So I came from here. This said I am going the right way. Okay. Yeah, so I've been exploring since the right way. And there's still been so much more to get lost in. So I've tried going forward. If I go back, I mean, I've explored all back as well, right? This is just items. Yeah? So it needs to be forward that way. Yeah, not back here. No, it's silver sim. So it has to be in this direction. I've tried going up. What if I go down? Okay, new item. So therefore, I'm going in a new direction. Yeah, another item, but it's dead end again. Fuck it, we'll fight you. Oh, maybe I shouldn't have. You know what, yeah, let's not. Let's get. Oh no! I failed to run away. Luckily for me, I had a bit of an evasion up, but yeah, still taking a beating. Okay, we got out. Oh, but he's still in the way. Wait, I can't get past you. Come on. Okay. Yeah, like one more. No, come down. Oh, I'm just waiting for his RNG to get him out of here. Okay. Yeah, I'm gonna die. I can't beat these guys. I have to run, but if I fail to run, I think it's game over. I'm gonna have to get incredibly lucky. Yeah, game over. So back to the bonfire, which is here, which is God fucking knows where. I don't. I need to get back to that X location because I was trying to go through it like quite systematically from that point. Oh my god, it doesn't heal me, does it? I didn't talk to the bonfire again. Oh. Well, where am I? So this is where I died before. So I need to just let this nerd walk by because I can't. No, go up, please, please, turn around. Please, kind sir, turn around, yes. I know you have it in your heart. Thank you. You are one of the kindest Pokemon I've ever met. So now I just need to wait for him to go somewhere that I can walk past. Like that. Yatta! I already got this item. Then I came down here, didn't I? True, I got stuck on my way back. Not on my way trying to get through him. Oh, fuck me. Oh, but Sandshrew's so cute. Sure, let's try to take it out and see what happens. I mean, I don't know what I expected. Oh no, I need to talk to the bonfire. Holy shit, that's annoying. Otherwise I don't actually heal. I've looked this way, but I don't know, it all fucking merges together. It's hard to keep track of landmarks when the whole map is the size of a country. I haven't been down here, have I? No, I have, apparently. Oh, fucking hell. I checked Fundiger's VODs to get like a vague idea of how long this game would take me to see if it's like beatable in one stream. Right, this seems new, and he did it in about 3.5 hours, I believe, according to VODage. He might have fast forwarded. But I mean, if this is the rate I'm going at, it's going to take me a lot longer. Okay, but this looks brand new. This looks nice and new. And promising. And look at that big, open, simple area down there. Not a bunch of like complex levels going over levels, just a big, simple, open area. Look at that beauty. Follow the path, and it will lead me to my destination. Isn't that right? Somewhere here. If I change the camera angle, can I see a cave entrance? No, not yet. Boom, big jelly. Where's the staircase? Is there no staircase? No staircase. Over there, I suppose. Whew. It feels good to be seeing new terrain. That looks a bit more memorable. How do I get off? Must be a staircase over here? I'd love to see what just a zoomed out version of this map looks like. It's actually massive. I'll fight some more things when I find a bonfire, because I don't remember how to get here. There's just too many ways to go. Item. Poisoned hatchet recipe. What did I say? Did I say hatchet? You did, yeah. So I've got two poison weapon recipes, but I do not have enough poison. I mean, obviously I should kill some more beasts, but I'm just a bit too lost to risk engaging in a potentially fatal fight. I thought when I crossed the river it was going to be alright, but I'm lost again. Okay, bonfire. So we can try to fight something if we want. That's beautiful, look at that. That is beautiful. But yeah, I feel like this is a bit complex for a first dungeon map. Like, I think it would have been neat if it started off with introducing it as just like a flat fields map, you know, there's just some ramps where you slowly go up in elevation and then like you get to more complex maps. Oh hey Dan, welcome. I'm giving this a go. I am incredibly lost. Not really, to be honest. I mean, I'm just having to, like, what the game told me was to look out for landmarks so that I don't get lost. So I'm trying to, like, memorize what paths I've taken and what paths I haven't. But there's so many paths in the game. Very lost. I'm slowly making progress. Like, I've reached, like, dialogue check marks, which tell me I'm going the right way, which is very helpful. The cacti that are suspiciously in pairs look almost unnatural. Does this count as a pair or like next to each other? Because these are two cacti. But this is a dead end. Small cacti, okay. I'll keep an eye out. But welcome. Yeah, any hints are very much welcome. Like those two, I guess. Those are two small cacti. Does that mean this is the way? One small cacti. Oh, two small cacti? Yeah, I was very glad when I got through a you know the part I'm talking about. Like at the start, it's very tall and multiple layers crossing over multiple layers. I looked over the river and I was like, oh, look how flat it is over there. Isn't that so nice? That was very much a relief, but I am still getting lost. But I guess the cacti are supposed to be a hint as to where I go. I will say, I think it's still quite subtle. But I see the tall pillars. But I just imagine the decoration, right? And like, at least what how I interpreted the dialogue when the looter pointed out the stone pillars was to use it as like a personal check mark since you're saying, like, this is the right way, hey, remember this stone pillar. Come here when you reset to your bonfire and you can't remember where to go. I feel like, at least, I feel like the tall stone pillars are more obvious than the cacti. I think the cacti are rather subtle. Because really it just looks like environmental detail. But again, I guess, I don't know, it's, you don't need a guide pointing you where to go, it's more, I guess, just like being able to keep track of the complex environment. Basically, yeah, oh, okay, I must have misread that then. Because yeah, how I read it was just Luther saying, like, it's important to keep an eye out for landmarks so that, like, you know where you are. Because otherwise, like, with the whole rotational map thing, when you rotate the map, it's very easy for locations where you've been to look like a brand new location. So it's like, hey, remember this tall pillar, so that even if you rotate the map, you still know where you are. I guess it was more based off that. But yeah, it is quite tough. I would say, I think it's maybe a bit harsh for like a first dungeon map. But it is very beautiful. I'll give it that. It's incredibly beautiful. Like, stunningly beautiful. But yeah, I think the cacti and stone pillars are a bit subtle. I guess so. That's two of them there. I already went up there, though, right? So here's another two. Oh, but here's where I came from. Oh, I'm going backwards now. So I do have to go this way. And then I want to go down that ramp there. Through here. Okay, here's two more cacti. No, but now I'm going backwards. Holy shit. No, I came up here, right? Oh, I can't remember. No, I think this is the right way. Yeah, this is new. This is new. One thing we agreed with One thing we agreed with Dusky is that even if a map works well as a puzzle in vacuum, maybe not. Yeah, so like, what I thought going into this was that this was essentially the tutorial. But now I'm here, it does not feel like a tutorial. It feels, I don't know, give me back my soaked hatchet. It's an antitoxin, so it's got less resistant, but it resists toxin specifically. Okay, let's put that on Telly. Yeah, like, I think, I don't know, it also doesn't help that I know there are the audio, not audio, the dialogue cues. I have been saving a little bit, but I'll save again. I know there's the dialogue that's been talking about it, but when I walked into this map, I didn't think it was a puzzle, so to speak. It wasn't really presented as a puzzle, it more just felt like a complex dungeon. And you know, like, normally you can tell the difference, you know, like you go into a victory road. When you go into a victory road, it doesn't seem like a puzzle. It's just like a long dungeon. But when you go into Lost Woods in Zelda, like, that's very obviously a puzzle. But when I've been walking around here lost and about, it doesn't feel like I'm missing a hint. It feels like I just keep on going the wrong way and getting lost. I don't know. But yeah, I will say it's not too bad. Like, I think I only just got your cactus hint and I already got through what I think is most of the dungeon. I think it's more that, you know, you just, like you said, you don't expect this for a tutorial. I'm using my hatchet though. Oh god, this sand through. Oh boy. Maybe we're not gonna make it out of here, Tally. Okay. Well, Tilly, I think we're running. Oh, about what you said. Remember, a dungeon can be a dungeon, but a puzzle is not about... I know, but it's like, if you're doing a puzzle, you tend to know before you start it whether it's a puzzle or not, you know? But when I started this, I had no idea there's a puzzle element to it. Like, nothing really came across as puzzle. Bye-bye, Tully. But, you know, to, like, be in a puzzle and not really know it's a puzzle at all is quite harsh. I think that only works for, like, the first 10 minutes of an area, you know? Like, I'm sure when you first walk into Lost Woods, you know, you think, oh, this is a weird map. And then you realize, hey, everything's just repeating and areas aren't really making sense. But, I don't know. Yeah, it's just stuff to think about, I guess. Like, even now with, like, knowing the cactus in, I still wouldn't really consider it a puzzle. Because, like, if the cactus is the solution to the puzzle, I guess there's two ways you could look at it. Either the cactus is the solution to the puzzle, and that's how you get through the map, but then there's not really a clue to the cactus to begin with. But, then I guess the other way as well, just think of a map as what it is, and the cactus is just a hint. It's not, you know, that's your hint to begin with. You don't need any extra hints. I guess that would have made it even harder then, right? Yeah, I mean, again, like, even as I started, I never expected there to be a hint for cactuses to lead the way. So I do get why the cactuses aren't really viewed as a puzzle, depending on how you look at it. Where the hell am I going? Down here? What? But yeah, I think just, in general, I think it's just a bit of a tough map for a tutorial. I was scared of them because it turned out to be harder than... Yeah, exactly. And I think even that has, like, still persisted a little bit. But I mean, if you've made this whole map, it's not like you want to remake it completely, right? So I do get why you stuck with it. It would have been a lot of wasted time to try to redo the whole thing. Just like, may as well just keep it and try to add some clues to make it easier. Oh, fuck. Okay, yeah, but other feedback. I really don't like it that when you faint, the bonfire doesn't heal you automatically and you have to talk to it again. Because I'm so used to, like, Pokemon games, or just any RPG, really. If it's a free healing mechanic, like a save point, not like an inn, because you pay for an inn, so that makes sense. Like a save point or a Pokemon Center, normally you come back on full health. But here, you don't. Yeah. Okay, remember to talk to the bonfire. Yes, I would like to rest. Yeah, I imagine it's just a small oversight, really. Hey, but at least from fainting so many times, I'm beginning to learn the map. I think, I say as I walk in the complete wrong direction. Okay, there's the cactus I'm looking for. Where's my slope? Not here, apparently. Here. Yeah, here we go. Off we go. Wrong way. Yeah. Yeah, this game is just utterly beautiful. And the music as well, music is really neat. It's all just really nice. Down here... Well, this is the wrong area. This is... yeah. Where the hell am I going? What? I've done this before. I want to get to the river. With the bridge. You go down here. Right? Do I just need to go further down? No, oh, this is a dead end. What? Oh my god, why am I... What? I did this! So I want to go down. Right, I go down here. Oh my god, it's because I thought this area... I thought that slope was this slope. I was like, I came from that slope. Why would I... But no, it's here. Oh god. Okay, and then I... go here. No, I need to go down again. Oh god. And then I loop around to the lake. Yeah, this looks right. Okay. And then I gotta beat this guy. Because he's standing in my way. Oh, it's change type. Okay. So, equip bow for flying type. And we can take down this ferocious condor. I do like how you've given them all like special names, you know. Very neat. There we go. Easy peasy. And a level up. Nice. True, is there a, if you get a super effective hit, like using a water on an earth type or something, is there an indicator, like a sound effect or something? Sometimes I'm not really sure if I'm using the right weapon or not. And I can't really like tell without changing weapon and seeing if it does a lot less damage or not. This looks fancy. Fancy rock, I guess we can pull it up. Oh, I've encountered a dude. Oh, I nicked it! Oh my god, it's so cute! That's so cute. I can't even bear to attack this poor fella. I guess I'll just go with whatever has the most attack, just my soak catch it. Look at that damage. Maybe I should have done spear. Wow, you're really weak, Nicket. Let's slide past this bird. Grab this item. Another hatchet. We'll get to make all the hatchet types. Gold. How did a pony get out here and plant all these items out here? I mean, it's one hell of a journey. She must be really cool to be able to make it out here all by herself in the dead of the night and leave health items around just for me to get as I wish. I sense cave entrance time. This feels like a special area here. Oh, here we go. I guess it's time to say bye-bye to Telly.